Welcome back to Engineering Nature. This is Mehul. Today I am coming with the second part of the methane-air combustion tutorial. In very first part of this tutorial, we had learned how to simulate the methane combustion with the help of Fluent. In the previous tutorial, we had using this geometry to simulate methane combustion with the help of species transport equation. The objective of that tutorial is to derive the temperature distribution as well as fuel distribution during the combustion process. Now in the second part, we will extend that study to calculate various emission elements like carbon dioxide, NOx, soot particles. So let's proceed for today's session. This was the geometry which we are going to use. These are the boundary conditions where we have air inlet as well as fuel inlet and single outlet. Now for combustion simulation, we had to specify the species transport model. Here we are going to use simple species transport equations to make the simulations very simple. Now NOx emission can be calculated by available NOx model. You just click on the NOx. NOx emission can be calculated based on thermal NOx, prompt NOx and fuel NOx. Let me show you. Basically, thermal NOx will produce due to the nitrogen present in the air. The prompt NOx is basically produced due to the combustion reaction. And fuel NOx is due to the nitrogen content within the fuel. However, intermediate NOx generally predominating during the high pressure combustions. So for our case, we are considering only prompt NOx. You should define the fuel carbon number as well as equivalence ratio, which I had considered 0.76. You should refer the equivalence ratio. I will cap all remaining settings as default in this NOx model. Once you define the NOx model, you can calculate the soot density by using the soot model. We have various options available. Based on that option, this Moss-Brookes model will more suitable for methane or gaseous combustion. In Moss-Brookes model, I am keeping all default setting. Just apply that and close this window. Once you activate this NOx as well as soot model, let's start our calculations. Go to the calculation activity. To save the calculation time without initialization, I will start my calculation by putting number of iterations. Now initially this calculations indicate the surge in the divergent side, but slowly it will converge. The residual for NOx as well as soot particles slowly decreasing, and within 20 iterations the solution will converge. Now let's see the result what we are getting. So this is the previous temperature contour which will not affected at all. We have a temperature, maximum temperature in the range of 2200 degree Kelvin. In the same way, what we have previously, the species, that is the methane distribution, the diffusion of methane. This is how methane will diffuse inside this combustion chamber. This will not affect at all. Now our objective is to look into the emission elements. So let's go to the NOx calculations. Select NOx with, you should select mole fractions. You can select mole fractions and just click on the display. So this will indicating the NOx formations, where red color indicating the maximum NOx formations, but it is currently it is in form of mole fractions. So generally the NOx emission is desirable in form of part per million, that is NOx generally indicating by mean of ppm. This one is the formula which I will use to convert this mole fraction into ppm, NOx mole fraction into particle per millions. So let's define the custom field functions. I will show you how can we write this custom field functions. You should define new custom field function from parameters and customizations. I'm going to use this equation. So you should select mole fraction of NO. This is mass fraction, so choose mole fraction of NO. You simply write this equations, mole fraction of NO, multiplications in the multiplications of 10^6. In denominator we have 1 minus H2O mole fractions, so you just divide that entire equations with 1 minus mole fractions of H2O. So that mole fractions of H2O we can find out in the species. So choose species and just select the mole fraction of H2O. So this is how you can convert NOx mole fraction to NOx ppm. You can give the name. I already defined this function, so I will not define again. You close it and simply you can visualize that result into ppm by go into the contours and simply select into custom field functions where we have a NOx into ppm. So this is how the NOx into ppm will look likewise. So this is how you can see the NOx emission into ppm, where red color indicating maximum ppm, which is around 25. So where the maximum temperature happens, there is a chances for maximum NOx formations. Now we can also see the contour for soot density. Select the soot as well as soot density, and just simply if you wish, then you can change the color. So you can choose appropriate color scheme. Simply you apply that and just you display that. So this black color indicating the soot formations, the intensity of soot formation is higher at this particular locations. Now let me show you the carbon dioxide as well as carbon monoxides. See, in the contour you just select the species. Now below to that species tab we have various options for mass fraction of methane, oxygen as well as carbon dioxide. Let's simply select the mole fraction of carbon dioxide, which will indicating the carbon dioxide concentration. You can change the color scheme. So this red color indicating the maximum carbon concentration. So that's it for today. You can share this video, you can like this video and subscribe this channel to support us. Thank you very much.